Juan, I actually have a question that's relevant to this one,
Sure.
to the first blue box here. So on the blue box that says use a platform that updates in real time as new employees enter and exit the business. Can you walk through, you know, why it's important to measure the culture of your organization over time rather than just like a one and done approach?
Great question. If you're in a retail operation, or let's say a restaurant, right? We had this client up in Minnesota that had a restaurant chain, and they had about 40% turnover. And so every month, 40% of their organization at this large 60-person restaurant was moving on and turning over, and they were hiring new people. That's really untenable to know what is the living culture every day when you have so many new people. With a platform like this, you can measure it, know the snapshot, let's say Jan 1, lose people, but learn from the insights on who worked out and was a high performing server with, you know, that got great remarks on the net promoter scores and the customers raved and came back and maybe even could upsell customers to buy more things. So the average basket of goods for a family of four was increasing from $80 to 100, et cetera. So revenue, profit started to move forward. To looking at the average performers and what the profile of the culture of those people are, but you can pull out the different subgroups, as well as the low performers who either were fired or quit. Once the system learns that, it'll then recommend what the profile is for high performance in the environment that this restaurant wanted, which was a profitable, revenue growing, high net promoter score, good customer service. And so, for instance, in measuring it over time, they started to get a better feel of what the right culture was. But some companies don't know what the right profile is, the right 28 characteristics. A platform like this will tell you and show you with through the performance of your own people. Don't let outside consulting firms tell you the best culture for your company. Let the performance of people in your company tell you that. You can take the high performer from Bennigan's and put them in TGI Fridays, and that might not work out so well for that person or that company, because what the culture is at Bennigan's and the culture at TGI Fridays, very different even for the same job. And so by measuring it over time, they learned and got to a better culture profile per server, per cook, per, you know, all the five positions they hire for. And sure enough, they increased revenue by 20%, where it was decaying. They got customers coming back monthly instead of biannually, but on a monthly, so 10 times more per year. Average check sizes got bigger, and their net promoter scores went from 2 to 4 stars on Yelp. True story, Minnesota, amazing restaurant and experience. So that's kind of why you'd want to measure it real time as people coming in and out of the organization. Retail and restaurant, there's a lot more change more quickly. But even at a Coca-Cola, you know, a large team will be influenced by a new member in that team, even if the culture is set and people measured it and it's understood. It's good to understand where that new team member fits with that team, where it doesn't fit with the team, and whether it adds diversity of thought and complements the culture or not, and where there are friction points or where there is alignment, even moving, you know, for somebody joining that's new.